Hey, you guys. You know what? I just got some new makeup palettes from Juvia's Place, and I am by no means am I a makeup artist, but I got a question on Instagram, and I said I was gonna start trying to like answer a lot of the questions in like YouTube videos, but I can never really find the time. So anyway, I'm just gonna make a video putting on my makeup that I'm playing with. I'm not a makeup artist, so don't judge me. and answer the question that I was actually asked, because it is a really popular question. So I'm not gonna say who sent it, but the question says, "Hey, I was wondering what started you on your journey to so much positivity, but directness. The whole entire motivation to cook every day, to eat very, very clean. What guidelines do you follow? Books you've read, things you listen to, things that help you along the way. I just love how you seem so strong, loving, positive, stern, and you hold your ground." Now, first, I will definitely say thank you guys for all the positive messages that you send me, because it is still very interesting to see myself or hear you guys describe me in your own words, because legit, like, to be honest, half of the time I don't think of myself that way. I'm probably like my worst critic. I have like Vaseline because I didn't want my lips to be checked. But for me, it just is still astonishing that that I have this presence, whether it be on Instagram and in person, and people view me like in such an amazing way. And I'm working on finding myself worthy enough and looking at myself in a more positive light. First part of the question is, what started you on your journey to positivity and directness? So I've said so many times on my Instagram that I am an Aries, okay? So I am just direct by nature. I think I put a lot of filter on myself because, you know, I don't want to seem mean or actually too blunt, but my directness is kind of innate. Like, it is who I am. And so for me, I feel like maybe, you know, I got like a cheat code because it's kind of like in my DNA. But I've always, you know, had my own mind, and I always spoke my mind. I mean, I might have had a little bit of more of a filter on that when I was younger, but once I discovered like adulthood and freedom, you know, I pretty much was like, you know what I'm saying, this is who I am. So my directness and my bluntness is really, you guys are literally just seeing like a piece of it. Like, you're not even seeing all of it. I could be really cold with my words. And so I actually try to work on that, being softer. Honestly, there are people who seem so sweet, soft-spoken, considerate, and I'm not gonna say I envy, but I admire that. Like, I admire people that are a little softer and less rugged, or, you know, just me. But my journey towards positivity, legit, like, it's still a journey. I have not by all means achieved where I want to, what I want to achieve as far as being positive. There are a lot of days that I'm not positive. There are a lot of days that I'm harder on myself. There are days where I just don't understand like what my purpose is. I feel in over my head, you know, I'm a mom, a partner, and I'm still trying to like kind of parent and raise myself as well for things that may have been missed, you know, when I was younger. Like, I'm headed towards 33. And, you know, there are still things that I need to learn and need to work on and need to fix. And you really kind of figure that out through, trial and error and experiences and relationships with people. And so I'm still on a journey. It's still very new. It's a day-to-day process. It's a day-to-day effort. Day-to-day choice, and every day is not successful. But I think, like, if you want better for yourself, as long as you're trying, like, that's all that really matters. You know, today is more of a good day, so I'm able to like talk about it. But there are days that I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to be positive. I want to be pessimistic. I don't see the light, you know, and that's just me being honest. So my advice to anybody as far as learning to be more positive is really just to be honest with yourself and give yourself grace, because you're not perfect. You're not going to get it right. every single day. You know, a little secret. I do not cook every day. Okay? With my work schedule and everything, like, I just do not have the type of time to cook every day. Now, I have recently committed back to my fitness because I am fluffy. I've gained some pounds, and I've recently committed to myself to eat cleaner and to eat better and to work out. And let me tell you, it's a struggle. Like, last night I went to the gym, and I was in the car, damn near about to cry because I didn't want to go in. Like, legit, in the gym parking lot. And I have those moments because I feel so overwhelmed that I have so much to do or I have so much on my mind. And so, like, eating clean and, like, working out and all of that, it's just, you know what I'm saying? It's a day-to-day thing. But as far as my decision to not eat meat anymore, because I think I've said it before, but I am not vegan. I'm vegetarian. I do eat vegan a lot of the times because that ultimately is my goal. But I am vegetarian. You know, I'm still on my journey. But it was 5 years on and off of not eating meat, eating meat. And back in LA, I feel like it's more of a culture thing. There's so many people that, like, are plant-based. So it wasn't really as foreign. I feel like it's getting trendy, obviously, everywhere. And a lot of people are looking into that lifestyle. But, you know, there was a lot more accessibility to things, you know, back home. It was I had to do a little bit more work when I moved here because I had to, like, find my places, you know, find the restaurants I like to go out to eat at and things like that. So, when I came here, it was during my pregnancy that I decided I don't want to eat meat anymore. Todd and I decided together, we both have been off and on, we both had dabbled and dabbled at not eating meat and eating meat and then just eating seafood and stuff like that. And so it was more of a spiritual thing for me. Like, for me, I really believe in, like, synchronicity. And so, like, I felt like I did not, I felt more aligned and more in tune with myself and Source, aka God, you know, the Almighty, whatever you want to call, whatever you believe, I'll say Source, but I felt more aligned when I did not fill my body with meat. I felt more clean. I felt I had, like, mental clarity. You know, like, depression and anxiety kind of, like, runs in my family, and I have less symptoms of that when I would go back and forth and I would not eat meat. So I noticed, like, a difference in my body. I noticed a difference in me maintaining my weight. I noticed me not feeling as sluggish or as tired, my energy level, my skin cleared, and things like that. I never really had, like, a lot of acne or anything, but it definitely cleared up when I stopped eating meat. And so those are my personal reasons. I definitely did at one point when I was back home, like, do it, you know, dibble and dabble in it because, you know, of trend. But I had, when I was successful with it, it was my own personal reasons. I attached my own personal reason and faith to it. And so I feel like that's what helped me be successful. So for me, that's the reason why. That's the reason why I decided to stop eating meat. And, you know, I just happened to have a partner that wanted to dabble into that. Also, cancer is, like, running rapid, you know what I'm saying? Like, so many sicknesses. And when you go to the doctor, high blood pressure, all those things that you start to deal with when you're older, they always say, oh, go plant-based. I feel like, okay, so if we're going to go plant-based now, you know what I'm saying? If that's what we're going to do, why weren't we doing that before we got these ailments or these conditions, you know what I'm saying? I noticed a lot of things when I first went plant-based. I noticed that for some reason it made other people feel inferior to me. You know, they would say things like, oh, I'm gonna eat meat, like, just announce what they were gonna do, which had nothing to do with what I was doing, and I wasn't even really vocal about it or trying to preach to anyone or trying to convert anyone because that's not exactly the type of person that I am. And so, you know, it just seems like if you do something sometimes and people feel like maybe, you know, you're so strong in it, maybe they, I don't know if they want to test you or I don't know if they just feel like, you know, I'm not doing that. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. But I noticed that a lot, like, what people feel about me has nothing to do with me. And so, or what I'm doing has nothing to do with me. So, you know, it is what it is. And so I just stopped feeding into that and it started happening less and less. I realized that once you actually, you know, once you actually stop paying attention to people or things that bother you, it's like it starts to go, but you stop attracting it to your life. So I don't really deal with like the commentary. I get a lot more questions now, like, okay, how did you do it? And honestly, your mind is very, very powerful. When you want to succeed as bad as you need to breathe, or you want to breathe, that's when you're going to be successful. Like when you have that drive and you want the result as bad as you need to breathe, like it's in you, it's a part of you, that's when you're successful. So I really feel like we can apply that to everything in our lives. You know what I'm saying? You are thinking about going plant-based and you just don't know how. You just need to do it. And honestly, sometimes those recipes did not come out great. Sometimes they were a little nasty. But being that I am a Black woman, I know how to, you know, mix and magic. So, you know what seasons, you know that salt and pepper is just not all you need. You know you need some seasoned salt. You know you might need some garlic powder, onion powder. Like, you really just got to play with it. And you have to put that effort. Just like it took you a while to learn how to cook when you were younger, like if your family or whoever taught you how to cook, just like it took you a while to learn that, it's going to take you a while. You have to be patient with yourself. And you get some vegan cookbooks. You know what I'm saying? There are things that I feel like you should naturally have in your kitchen. And, you know, you do want to have some type of plan, because if you don't plan, you kind of fail at it. And so I definitely do think it's important for me to probably do a video on that, because when I was transitioning, I think I was on Google and YouTube like every day, all day, trying to figure out how am I going to do this. You know what I'm saying? I think you're supposed to like blend this in with the previous color blush so that it doesn't look so harsh. I don't know. One of y'all need to teach me how to do makeup, because I don't know how to do this. But here we are. Keep on going. So this is really pretty. This palette. I always felt like I looked like a clown with color on, so, you know, I just ordered them and I was like, okay, cool, my friend is a makeup artist back home, and I just ordered them and I was like, okay, cool, I'm just gonna try. You never know. So, I wanted like a pink smoky eye type thing. I never was able to wear pink or any like bright colors, so I'm hoping that this turns out well. Anywho. Blend this out. Okay. So bad. Okay. Anyway, like I was saying, what was I saying? Oh, as far as like there's certain things that you definitely do need in your pantry, like certain grains and things like that you should just always have. And so there's certain ways for you to store your vegetables, because like the way I store my vegetables, they'll last like up to 10 to 11 days. You know what I'm saying? And I do think I need to do a video on that as well. So maybe that'll be next before I do another recipe. But anywho, like I was saying, you just gotta put some effort. Like, I feel like there are people who just want things given to them, and you just gotta want it bad enough. If you wanna be healthy, if you're making out the priority, then you know what you're gonna do? You're gonna make it work. So that's how I feel in regards to that. A lot of you ask like things that I eat in a day. Sometimes I don't eat enough, and that's bad. But lately I've been eating like yogurt, like a coconut yogurt, and like a banana or coconut yogurt with a little agave and some granola and like some almonds in it. With a banana or a piece of fruit. Sometimes I just eat fruit. Sometimes I eat like a fruit smoothie. Sometimes I do like overnight oats. Honestly, and quite frankly, I am not a breakfast person. I don't really like breakfast for real, but I eat because I need to. But one thing I am doing and being conscious of is drinking more water. Because to be honest, I just don't like water. It's just pointless to me. It doesn't taste like anything. It's a waste of my time. Honestly, that's how I feel. But it is vital. And when I was going to get my colonics at Heal That Self Atlanta, that's why I actually have two more sessions. But when I go get my colonics and Heal That Self, the lady told me, and she be telling me, like, you need to drink more water. Like, honestly, you know what I'm saying? You're constipated, which is, like, a little embarrassing, but that's what she be telling me, that I'm constipated. And so, you know, just because I eat healthy doesn't mean that I don't have other issues. And so the constipation is because I don't drink enough water. Your body is 70% water. You need to drink water. I hate water, too. You want to know that I hate water? Listen, we're together on this. I hate water. But we gotta do it. And I notice that when I drink more water, I feel like, should I put glitter on this? Is this even cute? Like, do I look stupid? Let me stop rambling. I notice that when I drink more water, I go to the bathroom way more. Like yesterday, I think I went to the bathroom, like number two. I think I went probably like three times maybe, literally. And one thing I do take is food enzymes to help like break food down. So that's also a suggestion. I use Nature's Sunshine is the brand that I use. And I'll take one, I'll take like two a day. I'll take two probiotics a day. I take a daily vitamin, like a multi. And I take a biotin. I'm not consistent every day. I'm not going to sit here and lie and be like, yeah, I do X, Y, Z, because I don't. I just, those are the things I needed to do. And I'm working on a routine. I am like a starter, but I'm not really a finisher. And I need to work on that. So, yeah. Also, a lot of people are asking me about my faux locks. I did not do them, but I love them. I got them done by Hermes Studio, and she was very, very efficient. I had her leave out, like, okay, so my hairline goes like this. That's my natural hairline. I had her leave out so many edges because I did not want my edges to be pulled. They're in for like 2 weeks and a couple days now, and when I tell you, like, I love them, like, I love them. I plan to keep them in for probably to like April or May. I'm not gonna tell you everything I'm using because, again, I'm not a makeup artist. And so, okay, wait. If I post another video, if you guys want me to do the video with me doing my makeup and talking, do you want to hear like what I'm using? Tell me, because I feel like I should only be telling you if I know what I'm doing. And I don't. Let's see. Set guidelines for myself all the time and regimens for myself all the time, and I don't follow them. So, like, I don't know if I make it seem easy or I seem like I got it all together, but y'all, I don't. I'll be struggling. Ask my man. Ask my kids. I get around here yelling, acting crazy. Not every day, but some days I'm doing all that. A really good book. I've read a book by Eckhart Tolle called The Power of Now. I actually found out about him by watching Oprah's Super Soul Sunday. It's really good. I just downloaded another book called A New Earth by him, and it was actually recommended to me by one of my good friends, aka like a family, like a cousin to me, India. She recommended it to me. She's on her journey as well, and it's lovely to see. So I'll be reading stuff like that. Mental crystals, I got a crystal book I'll be reading. And a lot of times I don't even have time to read, so I'm starting to get into like audiobooks. Because I just be needing to listen. Starting to get into that. And so, yeah. But if you want me to give you a list of books or give you some of my favorite books, definitely let me know and I will post like the books I'm currently reading. Oh, there's another good book I'm reading right now that's actually really good. It's called Love, Freedom, and Aloneness by Osho, O-S-H-O. And it's just basically about relationships and the attachment and how, like, you don't own someone and that how, like, you should be selfish. Because if you are selfish, then you're able to be a light to other people. Like, how can you not fill up yourself and want to be selfless and give all of you to someone? Like, it just, that's just, you know, I don't believe in that. And this book really guidelines and outlines that and gives you like a different perspective, because a lot of people think that relationships and stuff is like about ownership. And they think that relationships are, you know, there's just certain, like, you know, you belong to me. Like, and while I do believe in monogamy, I do understand that like people may be attracted to other people. And while like I don't, you know, want, you know, to be cheated on or anticipate infidelity, I do understand that people are human and, you know, But there's boundaries, and there's boundaries in relationships, and I have boundaries in mine, and we do what works for us. We don't have an open relationship, you know what I'm saying? But we do focus on each other's, like, freedom and, like, our separate growth, because even though we are good together, we're better together when we're good individually. So we definitely work on that. I don't know if that helps, but yeah, so I've been reading stuff like that. Into crystals, I got a crystal book I'll be reading. And a lot of times I don't even have time to read, so I'm starting to get into like audiobooks. Because I just be needing to listen. Starting to get into that. And so, yeah. But if you want me to give you a list of books or give you some of my favorite books, definitely let me know. And I will post like the books I'm currently reading. Oh, there's another good book I'm reading right now that's actually really good. It actually was referred to me by Corey's dad, my ex. And it's called Love, Freedom, and Aloneness by Osho. O-S-H-O. And it's just basically about relationships and the attachment and how, like, you don't own someone, and that how, like, you should be selfish, because if you are selfish, then you're able to be a light to other people. Like, how can you not fill up yourself and want to be selfless and give all of you to someone? Like, it just, that's just, you know, I don't believe in that. And this book really guidelines and outlines that and gives you like a different perspective, because a lot of people think that relationships and stuff is like about ownership, and they think that relationships are, you know, there's just certain, like, you know, you belong to me. Like, and while I do believe in monogamy, I do understand that, like, people might be attracted to other people. And while, like, I don't, you know, want, you know, to be cheated on or anticipate infidelity, I do understand that people are human and, you know, but there's boundaries. You know? There's boundaries in relationships. And I have boundaries in mine. And we do what works for us. We don't have an open relationship, you know what I'm saying? But we do focus on each other's, like, freedom and like our separate growth, because even though we are good together, we're better together when we're good individually. So we definitely work on that. What's next? Oh, I'm gonna do something that I saw on a YouTube video. Okay. Yeah. So that's that as far as books. And so this person said, I seem so strong, loving, positive, stern. I'm very stern. I'm a very loving person by nature. But I also can be a little negative, and that's what I work on. Like, honestly, my biggest advice is literally just to self-reflect and work on yourself, you know? And a lot of people said, work on yourself, self-care, blah, blah, blah. Listen, work is work. That shit is not fun, bro. Like, sometimes I be so disappointed in myself because I know better. I should be better. I feel like I should be further along than what I am. But you know what? We are all doing the best that we can. We all are taking it one step at a time. And, you know, like, you just gotta give yourself some grace. I think I'm gonna do a little highlight, but like a little. I feel like because these are really warm colors, I should do like a warm highlight and something that's not so, bold, you know? So, probably not in this all right. You guys, for real. I don't really be made up for real all the time. But I watch my friend do her videos, Cache, and she be lit. So, here I am, pretending to be Cache. So, I actually like this. It makes my eyes pop. Makes them look like extra light brown. The last thing that I'm gonna do is a lip. And let me tell you guys a secret. I used to have a real big insecurity about my lips. Okay? So I used to think that they were too big and I did not like them. And so I used to hate them. I wish they were smaller. So I'm saying all that to say, I didn't wear colored lipstick. And I probably shouldn't wear colored lipstick right now because I have color on my eyes. I probably should do something more nude, but fuck it. We gonna just roll with this. Cause I like my lips now. But anyway, I used to think that I couldn't do a color. And I would only wear nudes, only. But I'm actually, now that I'm kind of like getting into makeup and stuff, I'm trying to play around with it, and I like the way I look. This is like a Beauty Supply lip liner. And this is Kat Von D. I love her stuff because I like matte. I like to kiss my man. So, can we have a lip on? Lipstick on here. I like Kat Von D with her lips. I like matte. So I'm gonna let this dry. And then I'm gonna put a little something else on there. I hope I don't look like a clown. Please comment and let me know if I look like a clown. Because I'm not about to kiss Todd right now and I wanna tone this down. I'm gonna just put this over it a little bit to kind of tone it down. I think I look pretty. That's all that matters. Let me know. Do I look like a clown on this video? I hope I answered some of your questions. Don't forget that my locks are by Hermes Studio. I got this Cynthia doll hoodie from Rugrats from Cake Worthy Locks. They're human hair ends. I got butt length. She did ombre and she did really good because she like transitioned the colors. You know, I think these dreads are mine. I'm pretending they're mine. So, yes. Anywho. Alright, that's it for this video. I didn't do my makeup. All I gotta do today is, I'm actually about to make some more cookies. Because I'm learning how to make these, like, decorative cookies. And then I actually have a teacher conference. So I'm gonna wear this makeup to the teacher conference and this hoodie. Because I'm a cool mom, you know? Anywho. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching and comment, like, subscribe. Let me know what else you want to hear or talk about, whatever. And yeah.